light the candle.
Thank you, Lord, for just watching over us and for everything that you've done and everything you're going to continue to do.
Yes.
Yes.
We ask Lord right now to bless all those that are here in presence and all those that are listening or watching over the airwaves.
Yes.
Give them all the things that they need. Not necessarily what they want, but what they need, Lord.
Yes.
Take care. We ask you, Lord, just continue to bless our church and our pastor, our community, all the communities that are represented here. We ask you, Lord, to continue to bless our leaders.
Yes.
Look out for all of those that are sick and shut in, all of the bereaved, all of the homeless. Look out for our children.
Yes.
And do, Lord, do something about the gun violence.
Yes.
We just ask you, Lord, all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help come from the Lord, who has made heaven and earth. He will not let you stumble. You will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel never slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shield. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord keeps you from all harm and watches over your life. The Lord keeps his watch over you as you come and go, both now and forever. Amen.
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 Children often compare what they're given with what others receive. This means that as the doting aunt, I better exercise good judgment. I too sometimes compare the things God gives me with those he's given others. Why do I have this and she has that? I ask God. My question reminds me of what Simon Peter asked Jesus by the Sea of Galilee. Jesus had just given restoration and forgiveness to Peter for his previous denial of him, and was now telling him that he glorified God by denying a martyr's death. Instead of answering yes to Jesus' invitation to follow him, however, Peter asked, "Lord, what about John?" Jesus answered, "What is that to you?" and added, "You must follow me." I believe Jesus would say the same to us. When he's already given us direction in an area in our life, he desires our trust. We're not to compare our path with that of others, but we're to simply follow him. For more than 30 years, the Apostle Peter followed God as a courageous leader of the early church. Historical records also show that he fearlessly embraced death under the evil emperor Nero.
Yes.
May we too be steadfast and unquestioning in following God, trusting his love and direction. When have you compared your situation with that of others? In what practical ways can you follow God?
Jesus.
Dear Jesus, please help me trust and follow you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
discovered and reinforced family connections has continued to guide the African-American community through the tradition of family reunions. At these celebratory events, family history is recounted, traditions are taught, and bonds are strengthened through shared memories. Reunions are often held in significant places where family has historical roots or where new generations have moved and thrived. Many include a visit to NMAAHC, where families gather to reinforce their connection to the broader narrative of African American history. Thank you.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Announcements are as follows. Morning worship service each first, second, third, and fifth Sundays at 9 a.m. Bible studies each Tuesday night at Pastor's home address. You can join us via Facebook or conference line. Neighbors, Blessing Neighbors will be Saturday, July 27th at noon here at the Community Center. Our sacred shut-in list is Willa Garrett, Cynthia Hennett, Charles Simpson, Charlene Bradley, Pastor Ron Davis, Nora Cormier, Edith Ford and family, Nora Crawford, David Miller, Charles Tate, Otis Hanser, Ira Grady, Deanie Stetson, and Ron McKenzie, and our prison minister, Dr. Hughes, are right around the type on the left. Anyway, and the temple of appreciation for your birthday in the church.
I celebrated all month long in my own way. I did. I tried not to get up every day that I didn't have nothing to do before that. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. On last Sunday, and I can't thank Reverend Terry Henry enough for allowing us to go to Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church. He's the pastor there, to have our baptism. I was so excited about that. And we baptized three of our members on last Sunday. God is good. God is good. He's good. And today I would like to give them their certificates.
Amen. Amen.
Their certificate of baptism that they can take home and have. And do like everybody else, put it in a place that they'll probably forget they got it. Amen. Ain't that what we do when we get stuck? That's what we do. Amen. To God. But at least they'll remember that day. At least they'll remember that day. Amen. To God be the glory. Brother Willie Garrett had his family come up from South Carolina, his brothers and sisters and his in-laws, and to see him get baptized. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Gary, on behalf of the Living Bread Church of Grace and Hope, we're giving you this that it was done on the 23rd of June, 2024, your baptism. And we know you gave your life to the Lord before that. But you wanted to be baptized, amen. And the Lord saw fit to have it done. Amen. To God be the glory. Brother Richard Galloway, amen. To God be the glory.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I remember we were at St. James when Richard gave his life to the Lord. And he told the pastor, and told him quite frankly, he said, I just want to give my life to the Lord. I am not joining this church.
All right now.
You remember that? You don't remember that?
It's been years.
Yeah, it's been some years. He told Reverend Watson that, so he's never been baptized. Amen. To God be the glory. So he received his baptism on last Sunday. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Bashar got dipped twice because his grandparents come strolling in later. To God be the glory. And Jackson Jordan. Amen. Brother Jackson Jordan the third. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Jackson got his infant baptism as in the AMB church, as it is called, when he, well, in the Baptist church, we call it christened. When he was christened, when he was a baby, amen. But he received his baptism, amen, as an adult on last Sunday, amen. And Hazel was standing there, right there at the pool, standing right there, and said, "My daddy, Dada, going in the water."
She said, "Good job."
She said, "Good job. You did it." To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Jesus said, and it's not necessarily because some people didn't get baptized. And we know that the thief that was hanging under the cross, he accepted him, told him he'd be with him in paradise. He didn't get baptized. But then Jesus said, be baptized.
Yes.
Be baptized by water and by spirit. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory.
Amen.
So we're so thankful. So we are so thankful. Amen. As we look to the Lord right now, we have our altar prayer. Amen. And for those of you who don't know, when I do altar prayer, you can come if you want to and stand, or you can sit right where you are. Amen. To God be the glory. Because in our altar prayer here, nobody knows what, Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Nobody knows what they need to tell the Lord about better than you do.
Amen.
You know what you need.
Amen.
You know what you need. We just do a corporate prayer when we pray for everybody. But when you talk to him, you know what you need to ask him for. And then, while you're praying for you, don't let it be selfish. Pray for somebody else. Pray for somebody else. Pray for somebody else. To God be the glory. 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 Our sick lists have already been lifted up, the names and everything, so we just thank the Lord for them. And as we go to the Lord in prayer, our dear Heavenly Father,
yes,
Lord, we just truly thank you for being the architect of the world. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for being loving, for being kind, for being righteous, for being holy. God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you as you sit high and look low. We thank you for your spirit as it moves around the earth with us. We thank you for the spirit that when we come to know Jesus as our Savior,
yes,
that he lives within us. Yes. So God, we thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you, Father.
Thank
and Lord, we ask that you just look beyond our faults,
Lord,
and see our needs. If there's anything there, Lord, that needs to be taken out, take it out, God.
Yes.
Strengthen us.
Yes.
Forgive us for anything that we have done.
Yes.
And help us to forgive others
Thank
that have done things to us. God, we thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you, God.
Thank you.
We thank you.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we lift up all the sick and shunned, and we lift up every disease. We lift up everything because, God, you know. You know everything. And, God, you're everywhere. We can't even send you anywhere because you're already there. So, God, we thank you. Fuck the halls of the hospital. Fuck the halls of every facility that house people that need someone to take care of.
Yes,
and then, God, take care of those caregivers.
Yes, okay.
Whether they're paid or unpaid, take care of them, God. Strengthen them, Lord.
Do, Lord.
God, we thank you.
Thank
we
you.
Pray for our first responders, oh, Heavenly Father. We pray for them.
Jesus.
And we thank them. We thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We praise your holy name.
For the diligence.
Lord, we pray for traveling mercies.
Yes.
on the highways, God. You know all about it, God. You know as we traveled yesterday what was going on the highways and the byways. But God, we thank you.
Thank you.
We thank you. We pray for our holiday that's coming up, Lord, as people begin to travel just this week and this weekend. We ask, God, that you bless them. Bless them as they go to the waters, oh, Heavenly Father, to the beaches. Bless them, Lord. God, we thank you. And families go, let families go home. Oh, God, we thank you and we praise you. Thank you for the community, God, and thank you for our continued presence in Jesus' name in the community. God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you, God, for this service. We thank you, God, for just being God all by yourself. We thank you. Lord, this is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody say, amen.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory.
Yes.
To God be the glory.
Yes.
Be the glory. And before we get to that, I am excited. This is the first time we've sat in the pulpit together before, but this is the first time that I've been able to hear her bring a message. Yeah. Amen. To God be the glory.
Amen.
And I did tell her 12 minutes. Amen. I did tell her. And we tried to be out of here before 10 o'clock. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. So I'm excited to have her here. I'm excited to have my sister here to bring this message. Amen. To God be the glory. And to have her husband, I just told him he was introducing her. Amen. Come on down. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Elder Adna Swinford is my wife, and we're from Cincinnati, Ohio, and we're members of Word of Deliverance Ministries for the World in Cincinnati, Ohio, and she is a elder under the leadership of Bishop Bobby Hilton and Pastor Valda Hilton. She's also a cosmetologist and been in this field for many years. Phenomenal woman of God in the Living Bread Church of Grace and Hope is more than excited to have her here today along with myself and the family. And we can't wait to hear this message.
Amen.
And the Lord heard me and said,
Lord. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, come on, come on, huh?
Are you ready?
Huh? Go ahead. I can see it from right here.
Yeah. she says that.
That's fine. Thank you. I'm not here, but I'm good. And it's like packing the way that you have to carry what you carry.
Yes. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm so blessed and honored to be in the house of the Lord today, in the presence of my family.
Amen.
Moreover, to be in the presence of my family, that my sister is the pastor of this ministry.
Amen.
History in our family.
Amen.
A legacy in our family.
Amen.
And God chose her to pastor and shepherd the people.
Amen.
I remember, I want to give honor first of all to God.
Yes.
Lord. Who is the exact extreme head of my life.
Yes.
I know no other God.
Yes.
My Lord. There is none before me other than Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost, my helper.
Yes, Jesus.
God, my Father.
Yes.
And I just want you to know this morning, I'm honored because of the call that he had upon my life.
Yes.
And I answered. And I'm also wanting to bring you greetings from the Word of Deliverance Ministries for the world.
Amen.
In my church, right about now, we be stirred up on fire.
Right.
That's just the way where I come from. So if I get loud, if I go off to the right and go to the left, it's okay. God is still in control.
Yes, he is.
So I just want to take this time out. Someone wants to come in. Okay. And I want to take this time to share a little bit about my sister Phoebe, as I'm grateful to God for the opportunity that she's allowed me to be in her pulpit this morning. That's okay, I'm about 12. So Phoebe did her first sermon, I don't remember the year.
1997.
And Phoebe's first sermon was God Knows. I played it and played it until I felt the power of the Holy Ghost in the words. It ministered to me because she talked about the rich young ruler. Rich, he was rich. And I'm not going to have that sermon today, but I just want us to honor her as being a legend in our family that God is called to minister. So let us stand and act like you hear the music in your head. Let us stand. Let us clap our hands and honor her at this time. And that is to honor each other, to honor and bless one another as family members, as siblings. We omit some things sometimes when God just wants us to be able to say, you're awesome. I thank you for the call on your life. I bless God for calling you. I thank God that you made it to your family. See, the word of God is the word of life for us today.
Amen.
And many of us have been called out of the darkness into the marvelous light to serve. And yes, that's what we do when we've been called, chosen, and ordained. In families, we have to not be afraid to be able to bless each other. One of the things I found out, and I hadn't gotten into my message yet, y'all hold on, because it's coming.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We have to bless one another because we are bloodline.
Amen.
Yes.
Because we are bloodline. It's in the Bible that we're to do this.
Yes.
And I'm going to take it a little further. Phoebe and her family has chosen the name of this ministry. It's called the Living Bread. The Living Bread Church of Grace and Hope. Did you understand why you was given that name for your ministry?
I do. Bless God.
Now, do y'all understand why y'all's church is called that?
Well, I'm going to tell you.
Phoebe understood what the word is. The word is life. The word is the bread of life.
Amen.
And when you're being taught word that I hear her teach and hear her preach, I know somebody's getting full.
All right.
Now, what makes me know that is there was three baptized at one time. So God is moving.
Yes.
God is speaking.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I thank him for that. Now the name of this great church refers and references to living bread. And when we eat bread, we know that we can get pretty full. Amen. So the bread, living, is going to produce life.
Yes.
In us, which is the word. And that takes me to my message for today. Hallelujah.
All right.
Hallelujah. We're
getting there.
We're getting there. And it's okay to get that away. We get there.
It is.
Because God has a way of letting us know he's in control.
Yes, yes.
And there's nothing we can do about that.
Yes. My Lord.
Amen.
My Lord.
Amen. So I'm going to pray and ask the Holy Spirit to dwell with us and among us at this time. Dear Heavenly Father, you are the bread. The living bread of life. You are the word truth. When we study and show forth ourselves towards you, you make all things well. You bring forth life because you are the bread of life. When we partake of you, we can live. It is what we need to survive. It is what we need to live by daily. We thank and bless you. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, at this time. We thank you for your angels to surround and encamp around this service at this time. Thank you for choosing me. Thank you for this ministry. Thank you for our family. We thank you for who you are, for what you've done, for what you're going to do. We ask you to open now our ears, our eyes, that we may receive wondrous things out of the word that you have given, that you will speak, that will flow from your vessel, as I deny myself to be anything other than used by you on a daily basis. I reference you, I reverence you,
yes,
because
yes,
you're Lord and King of my soul. And my soul is not satisfied till you do what you do.
Amen.
And I thank you that the only way satisfaction comes is because you have showed up and you showed your way. We
yes,
ask you to blow your ruach breath of life
yes,
upon your people. Open their eyes and ears, their hearts. Saturate them in your presence right now in Jesus' name.
In your name, yes, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
As I was studying and looking and I know my time is short, but I told you how much this 12 minutes cost. JJ
can't pay for the words. Can't pay.
All right, that's what I'm trying. JJ told me to go ahead. Thank you, JJ. as I study the Word of God, I want you to open your Bibles with me to read in the book of Psalms, 119 Psalm. And we can stand and read the word of God together. And we're going to read 119, starting at the first verse, all the way to the 11th verse. When you have the word, would you say amen?
Amen.
Psalm Psalm 119. You get on 119, starting at the first verse to the 11th verse. Can we read together? Blessed are the undefiled in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they that keep his testimonies and that seek him with the whole heart. They also do no iniquity. They walk in his ways. Thou hast commanded us to keep the precepts diligently.
Yes.
Oh, that my ways were directed to keep thy statutes. Then shall I not be ashamed when I have respect unto all thy commandments. I will praise thee with uprightness of heart when I shall have learned the righteous judgments. I will keep thy statutes. Oh, forsake me not utterly. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word. With thy whole heart, with my whole heart, have I sought thee. Oh, let me not wander from my commandments. And the verse 11 says, thy word have I hidden in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. And I'm going to read the 18th verse. Be seated. And the 18th verse reads, open thou mine eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. The law is the word of God.
Amen.
And the only way that we can partake of the law is that we have to study it.
Say so.
We have to believe it.
Yes.
We have to trust it.
Yes.
We have to obey it.
Yes.
We have to not judge it.
Yes.
But know that it's there to do in you. If you study it and hide it in your heart, it will cause you to bring about a change.
My Lord.
And that's what God will do because of his word.
Yes, he will.
Only thing he needs is somebody studying it, getting it in their heart.
Yes.
Through Christ Jesus.
Yes.
And the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
We need all the help we need. Psalms 119 is likened to a puzzle, which describes and talk about the love for the law of God. Mm. And extols the beauties and excellences of the written word of God, found nowhere else but in the Bible.
Amen.
It says God's word is treated under these written words of God's eight designations. The law, which is instruction or teaching of God's revelation. The word, which is a general word for the disclosure of God's will.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The ordinances and judgments, which refers to our legal disclosures. Those places where we run into contact of things not going well among us, or within us, or between us.
Yes.
All right now. See, God has a word for that.
Thank you.
And the commandments of the authoritative order for us to obey. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for your word this morning.
Yes.
There are the precepts, which relates to man's moral obligations. There are things that God expects of us,
yes,
that we should commit to, because when we accept Jesus as Christ and of our soul, Jesus is Christ and Lord of our soul, there's some obligations that we're required, that we are accountable to.
My Lord. That's right.
And those places is when we recognize that when we run into trouble, with not necessarily someone, but with ourselves.
My Lord.
We have more trouble with ourselves than we do other people.
Say so. Okay.
What I found out about the Word of God and the love of God that I have for Him is that if you can straighten me out, if you can clear all of this within me, all the stuff that's lodged in my soul, God, if you can clear that out of me, then I can allow your love,
Jesus,
your Son,
yes,
your presence,
yes,
the Holy Spirit,
yes,
to allow me to become all who you need me to be.
Yes.
Through Christ. I always sign off on my messages and my letters, "In Christ I dwell." But it took a long time for me to get to that place. I had to ask God to cleanse me, to deliver me of myself. When I realized that the enemy had not had any bounds on me, because when Jesus went to the cross, and Jesus, y'all know what he did, don't you? He set Satan aright. And when Jesus came back out of the grave, and he went to the grave, he came back with the keys in his hand of life, death, and the grave. And when he did that, and he said he no longer have power over me, I believe that, because that's the word of God, and that is the truth. And I no longer allow anything or anyone to have that kind of power over
come
me.
Come on now.
Because Satan is now therefore under my feet, and I can... given us authority to have over our enemy. And look out now. Let me tell you this, what the Lord shared with me. He said, now the enemy ain't always the one you're looking at.
Oh,
the Lord said to me that the enemy myself, I have to ask God to forgive me.
Yes.
Forgive me for not saying the right thing.
Yes.
Forgive me for not doing the right thing.
Yes.
Forgive me for the ought against my brother or my sister. We family, y'all. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
All right.
I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ that delivered and saved me and made me whole. I'm not ashamed. When I got filled with the Holy Ghost, I told the Lord, thank you.
All right.
Because I needed some more help.
Yeah.
Some folks don't think they need more help. I needed more help.
That's
because
right.
I was sinking deep in sin.
Woo!
Far from the peaceful shore.
Yeah.
Very deeply stained within. Seeking to rise no more.
Yeah.
But the master of the sea, he heard my despairing cry.
Yeah.
From the waters.
Yeah.
From the waters.
Come
on now. From sinking deep in sin.
Come on now.
From my sin,
come on
he
now.
Lifted me.
Come on.
Yeah. Thoughts that cause us to have mental breakdowns, those were the words. deny the power of who he is.
That's right.
He didn't cause us to triumph because he wanted us to show somebody that we're somebody.
All right.
The kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violence takes it by force. You've got to be angry enough at yourself to tell the devil, you have no power in me.
Come on,
man. I have no authority in my life.
Yes.
My home, my job, my children, my sister, my brother, my mother, my father. You have to be able to know how to speak the word of God, which produces life, coming from the word hidden in your heart. God, if you can't remember it, the Holy Spirit will remind you. That's what he's there for.
Yes, it will.
So as we move on towards the end of my message,
amen.
We have to be reminded that the hidden word that we hide in our hearts, and God reminds us, see, the word of God are full of promises.
Yes. Yes.
Full of promises.
Yes,
it seems like the only thing we want from God is what we want. We don't want God to really save us.
All right now.
We don't want God to really heal us.
Oh, oh.
We don't want God to really deliver us.
All right now.
We want to keep on begging God. Begging God. Begging God. So you're telling God his word is not sufficient. His word is not enough. You've got to show yourself approved. You've got to study. You've got to get that word. You've got to let God's word do in you what he's promised. It's full of promises for us. But we have to yield. We have to yield. He keep reminding us to trust and obey and honor him and believe. And the other part of our lives that makes the difference is our prayer lives. We have to be able to treat our fellow man right in the midst of all things. We want to be healed. We want to be healed.
Yes.
We want to be saved.
Yes.
We want our minds right and function according to the word of God.
Yes.
We want it regulated with our heart.
Yes.
So we can survive.
Yes.
We have to study God's word. We have to get it in us. We have to pray. People say that they pray all the time. We pray, we pray, we pray. And I hear some people talk. I just hear people talk all the time. And one of the things that I know that when I became and had to come, when I became to the place of reckoning with the word of God, that the life that it presented to me, that I was healed, I was delivered, I was saved, I was made free.
Jesus.
Right. To live according to his word.
Yes.
Not the oracles of the land. The law of the land, truly, I can obey and abide by because I have gotten correction of the law of the word of God.
Yes.
I've been corrected to live in that law to survive the law of the land.
Jesus.
So, I found out that Adna, God tapped me because I would pray and ask him, there's so much more of you that I need. I didn't know what I was saying to God, but there was a pull and an urgency in my belly, in the spirit of my life, that I needed more. And I hungered and I thirst, not for food. I thank God for the word. I thank you for good food, JJ.
Yeah.
You know I love food too. But when I got the urgency and became hungry for God's word, that was when I realized eating God's word was such a filling to me. And I didn't know exactly what to do with it. We don't, because we hadn't asked him. So who am I with all of this power that you nurture? And God said, you are an intercessor. Intercede for those that was just like you. Intercede on their behalf. If you want to see what happened to you happened for someone else, I need you, he said, interceding on their behalf. I believe in God's word,
Jesus,
to the power of it, that Phoebe, my pastor, I call her pastor too because I recognize and I honor the woman of God that she is. She's my pastor too.
Ain't that what I call you, pastor?
Because I needed the more of God to know how to pray back him, his word.
Mama.
And when he said, all you got to do is give me back what I've given you. I said, give you back what you've given me. And now, when I read to you what I read, I'm telling God to do this for you all, for me, for this house.
Jesus.
That bread of life to fill the people. Let there be a hunger and a thirst of righteousness that flow through this atmosphere.
Yes.
That flow into the hearts and the minds of the people.
Yes.
That they're stirred up in their inner man. That the Holy Ghost will enlighten them. Will bring not only the bread of life, but revelation.
Amen.
They need to have interpretation. They need to have illumination of the word. And the word need to be inspired to live it out.
Yes.
Those are the kind of prayers that when you become that intercessor, God uses you to pray. So I agree with my pastor here this morning for her ministry to grow and that there be more like her children and the gentlemen here that accepted Jesus as Lord of their lives and to become fully endued with power to work to go outside these walls and pray and serve in the kingdom of God, that do the work that he's purposed and called them to.
Yes.
Purpose. And you gotta know, you gotta know you got purpose. Isaiah 43:26 says, put me in remembrance. Let us plead together. Declare thou that thou mayest be justified. Yes. This passage was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah to ensure us, and it's so meaningful for us today. Also, we have to do is know the word.
Yes.
Keep the word and remind God of his holy word.
Yes.
God's word says, call unto me. I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that thou knowest not of. Mm-hmm. God is not just a promising God. He's a promise keeper.
Yes.
He's a promise keeper. He would do exactly what he said he would do. We sit back and wait on somebody else. We wait on others. When God has given us freedom, victory, triumph to know how to carry out, we ask him, what is my assignment for today? What am I supposed to do? And if he tells you you need to go somewhere and forgive something, get down there and forgive it. If he tells you to go over there and pay somebody's debt, get over there and pay it.
Yes. Yes.
That's who he is.
Yes.
Haven't you just done this before for somebody?
My Lord.
Amen. In this Psalm 119, 105 says, the word declares, it is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path to lead, guide, direct, instruct, supervise, and keep us in all our ways, showing us and reminding us of his love and the love that he showed, we should have one for another through Christ Jesus. And Psalm 119 and 133 says, order my steps in thy word.
Yes.
And let not my iniquity have dominion over us. Mm-hmm. Did you hear what that said? Yes. Let not my iniquity, JJ, have dominion over us. Because we don't realize we have iniquities.
That's
and we allow our own iniquities
right.
to overflow everybody. Oh, my God.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, my God. Lord, forgive me. Forgive me for let my iniquities. My God, do you understand what iniquities are?
Yes.
That's what we're born in. That's what we're born with. So forgive me, God. Don't let my iniquities have dominion over no one. But let your love that you placed in my heart with your word through your son, Jesus Christ, and to be led and guided by the Holy Spirit. God watches us, Jeremiah 1:12, God watches over his word to perform it, to make sure it is fulfilled. His word have I hid in my heart, of course, to keep and be assured of the presence. love and statutes of his word. Luke 1:45 reads, and blessed is she that believe. 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 For there shall be a performance of those things which were told her from the Lord. Those things are the promise of God, that you are loved, you will be saved, you and your whole house, your children and your children's children. And he made sure that that took place in Mary's womb. He gave her a son.
Mama.
His name was Jesus. When God's words spoken out of his mouth, the scripture says it will not return to him void, but it shall accomplish the very thing he sent it to do. And these things shall prosper. What God sent it to do. When God sent his word, when you receive it, you can rest assured. When you think you have problems, it's your problem. It ain't my problem. God's just trying to get you together so you can live in the way he ordained you to live according to his word. It's not your enemy. The enemy in you has to be denounced. Yes. Let us not make the word of the Lord void by not accepting Jesus as Lord and getting the word into our hearts. Let us not make the word of the Lord void. See, when God said that to me, I said, wow, we're the one that make the word void. I'm the one that called the word not to do what it needs to do. And that's okay. Romans 8:28 reads, and as I come to my close, for we know that all things work together for God and for good to them whom have the Lord, who love the Lord, and the who are called according to his purpose.
Amen.
We all have purpose in the kingdom of God. What we need to do is find out who we are. Ask God to show us. Study his word. And a good place that I started years ago, and God brought it back to me, was in the book of Psalms. I need to be delivered. And if there's anyone today that is among us that need Jesus as their ever-loving Lord and Savior, the time is now to give your life to Christ. Because we're living in some times right now that seemingly to not make any sense. But we fight against it because we don't understand it. But when we live in the peace and the love of God's word, we know that he's got it, and he's in control of it all.
Yes.
And he created the heaven and the earth himself, and the world, and all of us that dwell therein. And he knew how to take care of his own business.
My Lord.
Thank you.
God be
the Lord and bless you. And the obedience of his holy word.
To God be the glory.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
Amen.
Let's give this woman a God. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. I've learned from pastors before me, you don't get up and preach nobody else's sermon. Amen. To God be the glory. She told about the word. And the reason why the living bread came to me was because Jesus said that he was the bread. He is the bread. He is the living bread. Amen. And I was looking at, Pastor Prince, can't think of his last name, and Joel Osteen. They were on a commercial together, and Joel said, I do grace. No, Joel said, I do hope. Pastor Prince says, yeah, he does hope. I do grace. That's what I teach about, hope and grace. And I said, Lord, is you telling me what? Living bread, church of grace.
Yes, and
amen. Say God be the glory. Say God be the glory. So I am so thankful, amen, as we stand all over the church, as we stand all over, thanking God for all that he has done. And anybody who wants to give their life to Christ, and to our Facebook family, as I tell them, when you give your life to Christ, wherever you are, don't be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Don't be ashamed if you've asked God to come into your life, that you believe that Jesus Christ died for your sins, and he is the Son of God.
Yes.
That you believe it in your heart, And I always tell them, find a church home. Don't think that when you know the Lord, that all you're supposed to do is stay home and watch television ministry. Fellowship. Go out, find a church, and fellowship with people. That's letting people know you're not ashamed. That's letting people know that you are spreading the word of God. That's letting people know that your light is shining. Because that's what you become. A beacon of light for the Lord. So we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We praise you. And as I was told the other day, that I never say that in that church home, come by the living bread. Come to the living bread, as I was told. You never invite people to come to the living bread. You tell them just go to a church.
The living word.
Amen. So I said after that, after I was scolded about that, amen. This church is open always to anyone who wants to come. To God be the glory. 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 And now, unto him. Unto him who is the peace that surpasses all understanding. May he rest, rule, and abide with us now and henceforth and forevermore. As we leave this place, but Lord, never your presence. Never your presence. Never your presence. Let the church say, amen. Amen. And now, Hazel, we can, Hazel, let's put the candles out. There you go. Amen. To God be the glory. Everyone is welcome to come to the house.